In this video, we're going to go over the steps to becoming a radiation therapist. So first, what are the requirements for a radiation therapy program? You'll need your high school diploma or equivalent. And if you're still in high school, it may be beneficial to take classes that are math and science based to help you build a solid foundation. Once you graduate, you'll need to complete the prerequisite courses for a radiation therapy program. These will typically be your general education courses with a focus on math, science, and physics. But keep in mind that these courses and your overall GPA will have to fall into a certain range for the radiation therapy program. You can always find the specific requirements for a program on the college's website. You may also notice that some colleges may require you to attend an informational college meeting or complete a clinical site visit at one of their affiliated hospitals. So make sure you're aware of all of the requirements for applications and make sure you're getting them done prior to the application deadline. And if you still haven't found the program you want to attend, you can find the complete list of eligible programs at ARRT.org under Find an Educational Program. Next, how long does it take to become a radiation therapist? So the length of time it'll take to become a radiation therapist will depend on a few factors, like if you decide to go for an associate's degree or your bachelor's degree. But here's a rough estimate of those timelines. If you decide to pursue a bachelor's degree in radiation therapy, that's typically going to take you about 4 years. That's 2 years completing your prerequisite courses and 2 years in the radiation therapy program. During that time, you'll complete the required coursework, you'll get hands-on training through clinical experience, and you'll prepare for your board exam. For an associate's degree program, that's typically going to take you about 2 years to complete. That's 8 months of prerequisite courses, followed by 16 months of program-specific courses. During that time, you'll get the skills and knowledge you need for an entry-level position in the field. Remember, these timelines are just general estimates. They can be influenced by things like studying full-time or part-time for your prerequisite courses, the way your radiation therapy program is structured, or any additional requirements from your chosen college. It's a good idea to investigate and talk to admissions advisors. They can give you more specific information on how long the program that you're interested in will take. Next, what degrees or certifications are required? For radiation therapists, we have to meet requirements for education, ethics, and examination. For education, we are required to have an associate's or bachelor's degree from a radiation therapy program that's recognized by the American Registry for Radiologic Technologists, or the ARRT. These eligible programs meet specific standards that will prepare you for a career as a radiation therapist. We'll go over different types of accreditation in another video. You will need to meet an ethics requirement. This will happen when you apply for your certification and registration. You will answer ethics-related questions from the ARRT to ensure that those holding credentials are qualified, trustworthy, and responsible medical professionals. You can review the standard of ethics on the ARRT's website. Once you've met those requirements, you're eligible to take your ARRT board exam. This exam will be taken at a testing facility, and on completion of the exam, you will be given your preliminary results. If you don't pass on your first go, you will have 2 more attempts to take the exam. For the most current and up-to-date information on preparing for your exam, what to expect on exam day, what to expect after you've passed your exam, and how the exam is created and the content specifications, you can find all this information on the ARRT's website. And once you've passed your board exam, you'll receive your credentials and you're ready. Almost. Some states do require radiation therapists to obtain a license to practice. Licensing requirements can vary by state and can involve passing an additional examination or meeting specific criteria by the state's regulatory body. You can find information about individual state licensing on the ASRT's website under Legislation, Regulations, and Advocacy. Remember, it's important to note that your specific requirements may vary slightly depending on your location or the institution that you choose. It's recommended to research and consult with educational programs or professional organizations in the field. They can give you the most accurate and up-to-date information on your specific case. Thank you for watching. Let me know if there's anything else you want to know about the process of becoming a radiation therapist.